second half is set to get underway here in Milwaukee inside the Valley Fields Seasonal Dome. Along with Eric Simon, I'm Patrick Reed. Notre Dame spaced itself out from Marquette in the second quarter to build a lead. And now for the Irish, a team that is looking at the possibility of an NCAA tournament berth, even without winning an ACC championship. There's still a path for them at large. This is a good sign to come on the road and have a dominant first half against Marquette the way they did.
Right. They're keeping the intensity up, and they're winning draws and ground balls right now and really handling Marquette well.
So the Irish with the opening possession of this second half. Notre Dame in the first half getting 5 goals from Madison Ahern, 5 points from Casey Choma. Choma with 4 goals and an assist.
Right, we saw tons of quick release shots, great intensity from the Notre Dame offense in the first half, leading to this large lead they have.
And it was exactly the kind of game that Christine Halfpenny looked for from her team. Looking for a road win. The Irish 0-4 in true road games this season. They have a couple of wins in neutral sites. A 6-8 record overall, 2-5 in the ACC, coming off their win over Pitt at home on Saturday in their senior day. And from here, it's a game at Louisville, and it's on to the ACC tournament, which will be played in South Bend. And there's some real importance coming home and a real opportunity. But it was all about taking care of business first against a Marquette team that had its best offensive output in program history here on Saturday with 24 goals against Butler.
Yeah, the offense was really dialed in that Butler game. They were able to score team goals. Individual shot selection was excellent.
Check from behind by Mary Schumar. Schumar on the Big East honor roll this week has a clean look at goal, fires one home, and Marquette's with a good start to the third quarter.
Yeah, they're going to need a lot more plays like that if they're going to get back into this game. A really great job, really great getting the stick up there. Good riding. Nice check. Checks away from the body to make a safe check. Good shot placement. A couple of fakes there. Moving towards the front of the goal and keep increasing her angle on the goal there.
Schumar, her 22nd goal of the season. She's not the big-time goal scorer. She's the big-time distributor for this Marquette team. 7 assists on Saturday against Butler to tie a Marquette record. And Meredith Black told us before the game that Mary Schumar had no idea she was even approaching that tempo total. She's not a stat kid. She's just, whatever happens, happens. I'm just happy to be a part of it, happy to contribute.
Yeah, I mean, and she's always dodging hard to the goal, but looking to feed to her teammates. A real team player.
Just the 12th shot of the game for Marquette.
Yeah, they haven't had possessions yet. Hopefully that'll change in the third quarter.
It's because of this play at the draw circle here. Notre Dame winning 16 of 19 draws so far in the game. Kelly Dennis, big reason why for the Irish. Blee trying to get that ball and has possession for Marquette.
I'll say that the Marquette draw squad has done a good job of making it a team ground ball, but Notre Dame is winning those 50-50 ground balls.
Speaking of ground balls, the Irish with a ground ball advantage in the game. So look at Lydia Faust, Big East midfielder of the week. Oh, by the way, she turned in a 9-point performance, 6 goals, 3 assists, scoring those 6 goals on 8 shots against Butler. Shea Garcia gets spilled to the turf. Offense continues for Marquette.
Nice job attacking from all corners here by Marquette.
35 on the shot clock for the Golden Eagles. Schumar, a feed to Lamont. Kyra Lamont with a 5-goal game against Butler Saturday. And Lamont with a strike here in the third quarter to make it a 10-goal Irish lead.
Shout out to the Marquette offense here. They kept attacking. Great feed from behind, quick finish. The goalie had no chance to turn and see that ball.
There's one thing you can say about the Golden Eagles offensively in this game. They've gotten 5 goals from 5 different players.
Yeah, and we saw that kind of production in the Butler game, right? Lots of – there were stars, but everyone got involved. The team offense is working how it needs to be. They just need more possession, more time with the ball.
So Marquette with the first two goals of the third quarter. They've scored three of the last four in the game. The Irish, though, between the first and second quarters, an 8-0 run to take control after Marquette had the opening tally of the game 56 seconds in from Lydia Faust. But it was all Notre Dame after that. The next six goals, a Marquette goal by Shea Garcia, then the next eight coming from the Irish. A run that included a couple for Casey Choma. So the Irish will settle into a 7-on-7 offensive set here. Madison Ahern, four goals in the game. Coming off a four-goal performance on Saturday against Pitt. And a senior day for Notre Dame that was a special one for Christine Halfpenny and her program because they were able to get together. They were able to enjoy a senior dinner before the senior night, which is something they couldn't do a year ago. And obviously not in 2020. So good times for her program as Maddie Howe works at X. Brenna Nixon is the new goalkeeper for Marquette. Amanda Rumsey started the game. Nixon entered the game in the second quarter. Nixon, the freshman from Bonnie Lake, Washington. Less than 30 to go on the shot clock for Notre Dame.
Yeah, nice long possession here from Notre Dame.
WLAX from the alley, a skip pass across and a score for Ahern, who was at the top of the crease, had a step on Faust, and Madison Ahern with her fifth goal of the game.
Nice patience by the Notre Dame offense there. They really used most of the shot clock, waited for a nice opportunity right on the crease.
And it was WLAX who just continued on and on and on and was able to find that seam and able to find the junior Ahern.
That illustrates the issues that Coach Black was talking about with the Marquette defense. They're a half step behind those cutters, and a team like Notre Dame is going to make you pay.
Yeah, she was talking to us before the game about, hey, scoring 24 goals is a lot of fun. Giving up 17, well, that's where we need to take a hard look at ourselves. And the difference between Butler and Notre Dame, obviously the quality of player, the quality of athlete you get, but, you know, she said the fact that Notre Dame has so many different players, both in the midfield and on attack, who can score, who can create, who are dynamic. We have to have our heads on swivels at all times for this group.
Yeah, that's for sure. They do have lots of weapons, and the speed at which they play offense is really impressive.
The Irish with an 11-goal lead. Ground ball pickup for Dennis. So another draw control win for the Irish. And for the game, that was number 18.
We've seen some intense rides by both teams here. Neither one is willing to give up the middle of the field.
Howe off the screen. Mary Kelly Doherty has put together a nice run for Notre Dame. It's a pass to the middle there for WLAX. An extra look, but the gold shirts were all around for Marquette. Jmielewski picking up the loose rock for Marquette.
Good idea to go back, use your team to help clear the ball.
Marquette at 81% clearing this season, just after midfield and before the restraining box. You see the contact drawn by Elise Smigale, who has scored goals in 11 straight for Marquette, part of a dynamic freshman combination along with Meg Byerly, who once again was the Big East Freshman of the Week. 33 in gold. She is on the field in the 7-on-7. Taken back by Choma. Choma was fouled, and a card is upcoming. So a woman up situation coming for the Irish.
Choma's got great awareness on the field. She's able to pick up that ground ball, draw the foul.
So off the illegal check to the head, the Irish will operate woman up. Again, running clock continues here in the third quarter. Here's a look at Hannah Dorney, stopped in her tracks. And Dorney will bring it back on the free position setup. Penalty time is on 1:45 for Notre Dame, with 5 minutes to play in the third. McHugh around the cage.
Nice pressure. Doherty. Marquette.
Pressing out to the perimeter. Quick movement, quick feed to the middle is saved by Nixon, who got low. Henry looking to get to the end line. The Irish think they have backup, and they do, as McHugh will start us back in. Notre Dame in the RPI today, number 23. 26 teams qualify for the NCAA Women's Lacrosse Championship. Off the spin, the shot, and a score. Mary Kelly Doherty, back post. A woman-up goal for the Irish, who extend the lead to 17-5.
Really nice job by the woman-up unit by Notre Dame there. Ball movement is crisp and fast. Really tough to defend, especially when you're down a player.
It's a hat trick for Doherty, who's had a couple of multi-goal games this season, one against Syracuse, one against Virginia Tech. Doherty, her 13th goal of the season.
Credit to her there. Great move and a nice finish, bounce shot.
So Dennis and Blee will set up on the draw.
Notre Dame won the last couple draws, but Marquette came back in the beginning of the third quarter here and won a couple themselves.
Well, Marquette has been one of the best teams in the draw circle, not just in the Big East, but in the country. 19th of the nation in draw control percentage at 56%, and first in the Big East in total draws won per game at just under 18.
We're seeing lots of communication between the draw control person in the center and those on the circle. A lot of cat and mouse on the circle. They're just trying to jockey for position.
Audrey Brett looking to get to the restraining line will find Jasmine Murray for help. Notre Dame making it difficult for Marquette to get settled, get set up. Here's Lamont, pass across, back post, Garcia. Marquette in motion off the unsettled situation, finds the back of the net to make it 17-6.
Well, as we said, neither team is giving up the middle of the field. Great job by Marquette, sticking with that ground ball, getting it up and out, looking, your eyes are up, attacking the goal. Great little pass there and a nice finish.
Give Samantha Galvin credit on the ground ball at the top of the restraining box. Galvin, the sophomore, was able to get in there, pry it loose, get it to Lamont, and Lamont with the extra pass for Shea Garcia, her second goal of the game, now her 40th of the campaign. And in her career, 111 goals, fifth all-time in points at Marquette.
Really impressive, and that's something that you're trained on from day one. You want to get that ground ball up and find an open player.
Clock continues to roll. A minute 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Clock has been running since the second. Ground ball pickup, draw control one. There's a look. And Emma Sacadado. Sacadado coming off a 5-point game against Butler here on Saturday, putting together her sixth hat trick of the season. Marquette today, a balanced scoring effort, but not enough. against a quality Notre Dame team at both ends of the field, and an Irish team that's, I don't want to characterize as necessarily being a desperate team, but they realize the stakes this time of year. They're good enough to be in the NCAA field. They just need to improve that body of work. 18th in the inside lacrosse poll coming in, 23rd in the RPI. And this is a team with a path potentially to a tournament, even without an ACC championship tournament victory. A win or two in the tournament would certainly help, but they maybe don't even need to win a championship to get in.
Yeah, and you can tell that they're kind of hitting their mid-season stride now. Everything's clicking.
Clock hits zero at the end of the third quarter. And after three quarters of third quarter, which Marquette won 3-2, the Irish have a 17-6 lead. Back after this.
Are back in action one last time at home for Senior Day this season when they face the Georgetown Hoyas Sunday here inside the dome at Valley Fields. Opening draw will be at 12 noon. Visit GoMarquette.com to purchase tickets today. Women's lacrosse in Georgetown on Senior Day, Sunday, 12 p.m. Coors Light is proud to support Marquette University Athletics. Enjoy Coors Light, mountain cold refreshment made to chill. Celebrate responsibly.
Fourth quarter set to go in Milwaukee inside the Valley Field Seasonal Dome. 18th ranked Notre Dame, 17, Marquette 6. Here's a look at the All-American netminder for the Irish, Bridget Dean. Saw a little bit more action there in the third quarter. Dean, three saves today. Dean, second of the ACC in saves per game, but that All-American pedigree has carried her into her graduate year.
Pivotal in stopping the early Marquette attacks.
And again, it was Marquette getting to work early, getting the first goal of the game 56 seconds in from Lydia Faust. But after that, a 6-0 Notre Dame run. Marquette another one, and then an 8-0 streak for the Irish. Kelly Dennis has been a big reason why today. 18 draw controls for Notre Dame.
And mostly team draw controls. They're getting everyone involved.
Talk about it. From a team perspective, that's exactly right. Dennis with 6. Diana Kelly with 9. Kelly is a player that Christine Halfpenny really zeroed in on before the game with us and the way she's playing. The graduate student defender for Notre Dame.
And you can tell she really wants the ball out there, right?
Here's Dennis on the dodge. For the Irish, we may have an opportunity to see a lot of different personnel in this fourth quarter. They want to keep that lead at 10 or more and quickly get back to South Bend before they prepare for Louisville on Saturday in their regular season finale, and then the ACC tournament to be played at Arlotta Stadium in South Bend all the way up until the championship, as the highest remaining seed will host the ACC title game.
And as you mentioned, they've been very good at home, so if they can continue to keep this going, they'll be in a good spot for the ACC tournament.
4-4 at home, and speaking of teams that have been good at home this season, Marquette 5-0 inside the Valley Field seasonal dome, averaging just under 20 goals per game. Sacadado looks to add to that total.
Yeah, the secret sauce behind Marquette's offensive output has been the draw wins and the ground balls, and they just haven't had it today.
Whistle before the Faust feed to Garcia. Free position opportunity for Lydia Faust. The Big East midfielder of the week putting on a show right here on Saturday. Faust fires high under the bar to make it 17-7. Lydia Faust with her second goal of the game and her first since the opening minute.
Really nice. We saw this is a good shot selection here. She goes a little bit to the middle, up high. And we saw the Notre Dame goalie stop one earlier, stick side high. So I appreciate her going back that way. And she finishes this time.
Shot it right over the head of Bridget Dean. So Faust this season now 6-for-17 on free position shots. Faust is a volume shooter. Six shots today. She averages just under 6 per game.
And she has a really quick, nice quick release that I think makes the goalie have a hard time seeing the shot come out of the stick.
Quick release. She's an outstanding dodger. And there is a reason why she has been a high flight scorer in her Marquette career. So Blee and Dennis back at the draw circle. Clock continues to roll. Under 11 and a half minutes to play in the fourth quarter. To the far side, Sacadado will chase. Check comes on the far side from Doherty. Blee on the ground ball for Marquette. Here's Garcia. Garcia with a check to the head from Wigan. Get a good look at Kyra Willamott coming back to her left side. Cruises in, dodges right. The help comes from Kelly. And a free position chance for Marquette.
In the first hash on the right side. Not a great angle, but she can still shoot it. She moves to the center of the...
Likes to work the perimeter. Irish getting physical defensively with Marquette.
Yeah, you've seen it all game. They've been pressing out and very intense. Now they just need to have some little discipline with their bodies.
Their coach really likes the efforts of the last few weeks from this team. Every week is a challenging week in the ACC. A couple weeks ago, a loss at Boston College, the second-ranked team of the country. There's Sacadado on the run. And a celebration from Emma Sacadado. Clock will stop. Marquette up 17-8.
Really nice balanced team attack from Marquette on that one. They attacked from all corners. Defense was a little out of position when this dodge comes. And then a really nice finish. High.
Now, if you're Notre Dame, it's time to clamp down. Marquette has brought it to a 9-goal game. They would have to work quickly to make this a 2, even 3-goal game. But, you know, Marquette, Eric, does have a history of making second-half comebacks. You need look no further than their Big East opener against UConn to see that.
Yeah, and, you know, it all comes down to the kind of whole scheme that Coach Black has designed. Anyone can slot into any position,
yep.
And there's a focus on winning draws.
So Belie will take this draw against Kristen Shanahan. Giving Kelly Dennis a break. Belie, the face-off get-off player, as Coach Black refers to her as. Faust ground ball. Faust running into some trouble. Henry will support her. And Ellie Henry coming off a nice game against Butler. 9 draw controls. And just continues to eat up ground balls and eat up draws for the Golden Eagles.
Yeah, big one holding on to this possession right here.
Notre Dame possession. Choma, midfield, she is met. Her pass back, dropped by Wigan. Wigan will keep it moving, though, and get the Irish to the offensive end of the field. Notre Dame enters the box, trying to extend it back to a 10-goal lead and keep that clock running on Marquette.
It's been a second since Notre Dame's been in settled offense here.
Yeah.
I think they're going to take some time. Get settled.
So you see Howe working it around the horn to Madison Ahern. Ahern on a 5-goal day, face dodges and shoots it wide.
Notre Dame's had a lot of success attacking from the top today.
It'll be Marquette possession and success offensively. 26 shots to Marquette, 17. The Golden Eagles in the second half will have outscored the Irish 5-2. Nixon looking for an outlet. Marquette has cleared 6 of 8 in the game. Chmielewski will bring it into the restraining box to make it 7 of 9.
A pretty good percentage given that neither team is letting them have it. They're both riding pretty hard.
Yeah. Really not that many transition opportunities either in this game. Both teams have been in settled offenses. Notre Dame in the first half, Marquette here in the second.
Yeah. The most we've seen in the middle of the field is the draw control and the team ground balls off of draws.
Schumar looks to roll her defender. That's Megan Scudero. And Mary Schumar coming off a record-setting day here on Saturday. 7 assists. A Marquette record and a 24-17 win over Butler. Opposite wing, shot on the run, will draw a pipe, and it'll come to a Notre Dame cross as Kelly will bring it back.
That was a good attempt there. They switched the field off the free position real quick. Couldn't finish.
Head up for Diana Kelly. Gets it past Schumar. So the Irish will set up shop. That's WLAX at X.
They got more than a minute on the shot clock. They're going to let everyone get a touch, work it around the perimeter. Attack from the top again.
Looking for a good possession. There's a horn on the field, and there's a timeout for Christine Halfpenny and Notre Dame. With the Irish ahead by 9 on Marquette, 6:22 to play in the fourth quarter here in Milwaukee. So for Marquette, still a couple of Big East regular season games remaining. They will be back at home on Sunday for their senior day to welcome in Georgetown. Boys 2-1 in the Big East, 7-7 overall. And they'll close out the regular season at Denver. The Pioneers ranked 9th in this week's poll. 3-0 in the Big East, 13-1 overall. Is Denver eking out a win at Georgetown on Friday by a pair 14-12. And of course, this all leads up to the Big East tournament where the top 4 teams in the Big East get in. And right now, Marquette in good position to be one of those teams at 2-1.
They are in great position. And they, like you said, they got those 2 tough games coming up. So it'll be a good test to see how things will go in the Big East.
Meanwhile, the Irish will be at Louisville Saturday and then back onto their home field for the ACC. ACC tournament. ACC tournaments includes all nine teams. A play-in game between seeds number 8 and 9. The championship game will be contested in the home field of the top remaining seed. Schumar and Marquette fighting their stride offensively in the second half. But for Notre Dame, a couple of big runs over the first 30 minutes of the game, 6-0 and 8-0 respectively, changed the course of this game. It's the ninth all-time meeting between the two programs. Notre Dame has won the previous eight. Six minutes, 15 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, 17-8. The Irish lead Marquette. One more goal puts us back into the running clock zone. That'll be a big help for the Irish trying to run a good set out of the timeout.
Yeah, this sweeping offense, attacking from the top.
Casey Choma has it. Ahern, back to Choma. Now Mary Kelly Doherty will roll off right. Choma looking for a lane, final 10 seconds. Nixon has a stick out into that passing lane. And Brennan Nixon's got great reach, that 5'10" stature.
Really nice awareness. You'll see she steps out of the goal a little bit when the ball's behind, so they easily pick off those passes.
5:20 to go in the fourth quarter, 17-8. Notre Dame with the lead on Marquette. And the push will give it to the Irish.
Again, neither team giving up the middle of the field.
Here's Kelly. Dorney brings it in right side. Dorney cruising behind with 5 minutes to go. Irish looking for one good possession to put it away and put it out of reach for pesky Marquette. Choma looks to the front. Ahern. Hand off. Dorney. Chmielewski on her. Dorney spins, fires, and scores. Hannah Dorney for the Irish.
Notre Dame goal, Hannah Dorney.
That's a really nice job. This is what I like to think of as a typical women's lacrosse motion offense. Sweeping from the corners across the front of the goal, making the goalie move back and forth, and then a nice little roll dodge there. Turn and shot. She uses the defense as a screen there.
Shanahan, the benefit of the handoff for Hannah Dorney, her first goal of the game, her seventh of the season. The 32nd goal of her Notre Dame career, and the captain for the Irish extending the lead back to 10, and the running clock back in effect for Notre Dame and to try to get out of here and back to South Bend a little quicker.
Yeah, it's a really impressive. Nothing special, but every single Dodger is attacking to the middle of the field. They've got that pass to the perimeter. They got the little handoff if they want to do it.
So a successful run for Notre Dame stepping inside to face Marquette. Marquette loves its home field advantage here inside the seasonal dome at Valley Fields. Artificial turf surface, a little bit of a shorter surface as well, shorter than Notre Dame plays on at Arlotta Stadium. And Christine Halfpenny said, yeah, that's a factor. That's a home field factor that Marquette can certainly work with. Picked up on the far side. Moat looking for the outlet, finds it in Kelly. Kelly turning on the run, hits Hannah Dorney, the last goal scorer for Notre Dame. Stick up for Dorney. Dorney checked from behind. And it's picked up there for the whistle. As for Marquette possession with the clock approaching 2.5 minutes in the fourth.
Nice look up the field by the Marquette goalie.
So Marquette will look ahead to Georgetown here on Sunday. Compared to past seasons, it's definitely a beatable Georgetown team for Marquette. Still talented. Still a lot of players from a Big East championship team. They'll be rolling into Milwaukee here on Sunday. Dodge and a score for Lily Dietrich. Third goal of the season for Dietrich. Clock will stop. Notre Dame up 18-9.
Nice offensive set here again. They're taking, and now Marquette's taking from the top. Fake. Dodge and a bounce shot. Finish.
Nice look by Dietrich. Big time high school player at Unionville High School in Pennsylvania. 44 goals in her senior season. And has 3 in her freshman campaign for Marquette. Are valuable minutes for a player like her.
Mm-hmm. Continue to develop that explosive step that she uses when she dodges.
Yeah. And I would say from a Marquette perspective, Eric, this was a good second half. This was a second half where they got the train back rolling in the right direction after Notre Dame had a dominant series of runs in the first half. And if you're Meredith Black, you like the second half leading into a tough game here against Georgetown Sunday.
Yeah, you leave on a high note.
For the Irish on the other side of things, a big win will bring them back into the ACC this weekend. McHugh on the far side. Field rolling the cage. Under 90 seconds to play in regulation. See how much of this shot clock Notre Dame uses. As Marquette will clear. Here's a look at Audrey Brett. The speedy defender for the Golden Eagles brings it in on the right side. She'll stop, and to the middle it comes for Byerly. The Big East freshman of the week hitting the turf. Meg Byerly drawing a penalty here in the final minute and a second. Byerly has been on an incredible run for Marquette. She has scored in 11 straight games and has been arguably one of the most consistent offensive players for the Golden Eagles.
Yeah, she's got a great stick and great awareness.
What a transformation it's been for a player in Meg Byerly, who probably didn't expect to have this level of involvement this season, but on the free position scores to make it 18-9. Check that, 18-10.
Really nice presence there. You'll see her tuck the stick a bit to protect it, and then a quick release on the shot. And here she brings it in. Nice finish.
First of the game for Byerly, her 24th of the season. Marquette, the woman up goal is its 16th of the season. Under a minute to play. Blee with the draw win. Here comes Jasmine Murray. Murray with Dennis watching her swims through. Marquette will look for one more good possession to close this game out. And then both teams will turn the page back to conference play. Notre Dame to Louisville, Marquette to Georgetown. Shot on the run by Byerly, fought off. A save made by Lily Callahan. Callahan seeing some late work in this game in relief of Bridget Dean.
We
get a late card.
Oh, yeah.
So Elise Smigail is carded in the final 17 seconds of the game.
Got a bit too physical there in the middle of the field.
17 ticks to go. An 8-goal lead. Dangerous contact, the penalty for Smigail. Schlageter brings it into the box. Dennis into open space. Shots and a score on the far side from McAvoy. The goal counts for McAvoy. Her sixth of the season. And that puts an exclamation point on Notre Dame's 19-10, a win over Marquette for the Irish. Their first true road win of the season. McAvoy scoring it with a crowd of gold shirts around her just before the horn. And for Notre Dame, a lot of reasons to celebrate. Road win number one, they get to 7-8 overall. And they have some momentum going into the final weekend of ACC play. And Eric, if you're Marquette, well, a little bit of momentum from a good second half here against the Irish.
Right, both these teams, neither of them gave up, played to the very end, and now they're getting ready for conference play.
They'll get ready for Georgetown. Marquette outscoring the Irish 7-4 in the second half, but for Notre Dame, a couple of big runs in the opening period, 6-0 and 8-0. For Notre Dame, they win 19-10 over Marquette today. That'll do it for us from Milwaukee as the Irish, the 18th ranked team of the country, pull out a road win today. For Eric Simon and for our crew, I'm Patrick Reed saying so long from the Valley Field Seasonal Dome. The Irish with road win number one this season. And both teams will close out conference play this weekend and in the coming weeks. So long from Milwaukee.
Kira Lamont, Mary Schumacher, and Meg Byerly scored one. For Notre Dame, Madison Ahern led the way with 6 goals. Casey Choma had 4.